Welcome students in the online classes by Chandra Public School Mau. Now here I am going to discuss about the irrational number. In the previous class I had discussed about the different numbers like integers, whole numbers, rational numbers. Now here I am going to explain irrational number. A number that cannot be represented in the form of P by Q is called irrational number. So here I am going to take certain examples. For example, if I am going to write root 2, root 3, root 5, pi. So these are the irrational numbers. Now next is real numbers. The combination of both rational and irrational number is called real number. It means if collectively rational and irrational numbers are called real numbers. Now I am going to explain the real numbers and their decimal expansions. Suppose that if I am going to take a rational number, here it is 13 by 6. It is the rational number, it is in the form of P by Q. If I am going to find the decimal value of 13 by 6, if you are going to divide 13 by 6, you will get 2.1666 and so on. Here I am going to explain that 13 divided by 6, then 6 to the 12, here it will be 1, then put the decimal here, then 6 1 the 6, now 4, then again 6 6 the 36, then 4, again 0 6 6 the 36. And 4, and it will be go through up to the infinite. So here you will get the 6, 6, 6 and so on. So the decimal value of 13 by 6 is 2.1666 and so on. Here I am going to take another example. Suppose that 7 upon 8. If you are going to divide, you will get here. I am going to explain with the example here. Here 7 divided by 8, so it will be, put the decimal, now here it will be 0, 8 8 is 64, then 6, again it will be 8 7 is 56, then 4, 8 5 is 40, and here you are going to get the remainder 0. So it can be written as 7 by 8 equal to 0.875. So here I am going to get two kinds of rational numbers. In the first case, here decimal is not going to be terminated. It means ki you are not going to get the remainder 0 in any of the step. But here at a certain step, you will get the remainder 0. For example here, after certain steps, you are going to get the remainder 0. So your first number, that is called the non-terminating decimal, and it is called terminating decimal. That is non-terminating. Non-terminating means its decimal is not going to be terminated. The 6 will be up to infinite time. And here after a certain step, the decimal is going to be terminated. So that's why it is called the terminating decimal. Here in this rational number 13 by 6, you will get that a certain digit will be repeated. Here you are going to find 6 is going to be repeated. So it can be written like this, 2.16, and here it is called the bar. If you are going to make a line over that 6, that is called the here bar. It means that 2.1 and 6 is going to be repeated up to infinite. So it is written and as 2.16 bar. Now here I have written the three numbers. First is 13 by 6. It is in the form of P by Q and its equivalent decimal value is 2.1666 and so on. 13 by 6 is the rational number. It is in the form of P by Q. So 2.1666 also it is a rational number. 7 by 8 is a rational number. Its equivalent is 0.875 in the decimal. So 0.875 is also a rational number. So here in this number, after a certain position, a digit is going to be repeated. So it is called the non-terminating and recurring. non-terminating recurring year repeating. Both the words are used, non-terminating and repeating, and non-terminating and recurring number. Here it is called the terminating number. It is the terminating reason is that after a certain step, the decimal is going to be terminated. Here I have written another number root 2. If you are going to find the value of root 2, you can find it by the long division method. You will get 1.414213356 and again you will get the numbers up to infinite. Here in this number you are going to get that there is no any digit, a certain combination of digit which is going to be repeated. So here it is called non-terminating. It is called non-terminating and non-repeating, recurring. Non-terminating and non-repeating, non-terminating, non-recurring number. So again we can say that ki non-terminating and repeating and terminating numbers are rational numbers, but non-terminating and non-repeating numbers are irrational number. Here root 2 is irrational. So here you will find that ki any number written in the square root, and if it is not a perfect square number, that will be always irrational number. For example, root 3, root 5, root 15. So 3, 5, 15, these are not the perfect square numbers. So here in the root, if these non-perfect square numbers are written, then these are called irrational number. But if I am going to write a number which is a perfect square, suppose that root 16 equal to 4. 4 is a rational number, so that's why root 16 is also a rational number.